Hey guys, what's up? It's Roblox Jumbo here, and welcome back to yet again another video, and today we're going to be going over why Adopt Me is the worst game on Roblox. But if you guys are new to this channel, please make sure to go ahead and click that subscribe button and hit the post notification bell, as we do post weekly Roblox content just like this very video, and it would be an absolute shame if you were to miss out on any of it. Anyways guys, without any further interruptions, let's go ahead and jump right into today's brand new video. So what happened to this wonderful game? Well, there is a lot. For starters, they may be getting sued by one of their former players. Well, who could it be? Well, they were a former YouTuber as well, and they actually played a good amount of Adopt Me on their channel. We'll give you guys the count of three to guess, so go ahead and get ready down in the comment section below. 1, 2, 3, it's Jeremy. Now, as you all know, Jeremy was a massive Roblox YouTuber back in the day who played a lot of Adopt Me. He did some glitches and hacks videos, and the gameplay he uploaded was usually not the main focus of the video. Well, despite all of that though, Jeremy ended up getting banned for his outrageously inappropriate behavior, and only the game Adopt Me banned him and not the entire site of Roblox. He was very, very frustrated and called out Adopt Me for this ban that had little to no explanation on their end, and he even called out other Adopt Me YouTubers for not acting up and saying something to the devs about the situation. They didn't do or say anything, so he called them out for that, and one of the biggest people he called out was Leah Ash. Now, for those of you that don't already know that much about her, Leah Ash is a Roblox YouTuber with over 4 million subscribers, formerly known for uploading every single day, but she decided to stop for a break and she came back. Anyway, she covers stuff on Adopt Me, roleplays, and even real life videos. She is known well across the Roblox community, and it's quite obvious as to why she is. Well, because of Leah not acting on the situation, he is not only attempting to sue Adopt Me, but he will also try to sue Leah Ash as well. What would Leah Ash be getting in trouble for? Well, the charges he is going to try are criminal negligence ones. He's planning on trying to get her to give him a lot of money since she knew something shady was going on and decided not to act on it. So what would Adopt Me be getting charged for though? They would probably be getting charged for falsely removing a player. This is a secret legal battle Jeremy has actually been fighting for months, but he keeps on losing at every turn. Now that is the cover story on the court case, but he's actually trying to sue them for the pet feature as well. He was planning on making his own Roblox pet game, but Adopt Me developers actually stole his idea according to him. And that's not even all. Adopt Me has a really bad problem with its game, and there are hundreds if not thousands of players who get scammed on a weekly if not monthly basis. Now it's getting to the point where Roblox is wanting to shut the game down because this has caused them several massive issues. Due to high cost of pets within the game, so with some of the rare pets selling up to $100, a large subculture of scammers has risen up within Adopt Me. As the primary user base of Adopt Me is on average younger than the rest of Roblox, they are especially susceptible for falling to scams. Now, one of the most common ways in which scammers carry out their operation is through quote unquote trust trades, in which the scammer will actually try to manipulate the player to trust them into trading a rare virtual item in return for nothing with the promise of getting a better deal back later on down the road. The scammer will then leave the game with the victim's virtual item, leaving the victim will have nothing and no way to actually get it back. Now on November 5th of 2020, Adopt Me actually released several new features focused around combating scams, including the introduction of trade licenses that are required to be earned before one can trade pets above uncommon rarity. The amount of pets you can trade and the addition of a viewable trade history and the addition of notifications to the player if the game detects a markedly unfair trade. So this is definitely a good feature on their part, so they are fixing up this game, however there are still several issues. Well, anyways guys, thank you all so much for watching this video, and if you enjoyed it, please make sure to go ahead and click the like button and let us know down in the comment section if we miss out on anything going on in the video. Also make sure to subscribe as well. Anyways, it's been Roblox Jumbo and we are out. Peace out, have a great day, and bye bye.